Good day, ma'am. We are the group 4 and we will gonna present to you the issues of diversity, particular in gender. So, difference between sex and gender. Sex, person's characterization as female or male at birth, typically based on appearance of external genitalia or other biological characteristics. Sex refers to the different biological and psychological characteristics of males and females, such as reproductive organs, chromosomes, hormones, and etc. Gender. Social characteristics may be or not be aligned with a person's sex and adapted by individual as their gender identity. Gender refers to the socially constructed characteristics of women and men, such as norms, roles, and relationship between the groups of women and men. It varies from society to society and can be changed. Sex, a determination made through the application of socially agreed upon biological criteria for classifying persons as females or male. The criteria for classification can be genitalia at birth or chromosomal typing before birth.
Sex category. Ang sex category daw po is ito ay ang male at female. Sa placement po dito is, yung sinasabing placement po dito is yung in a sex category, ma-achieve lang ito pag pasado siya sa sex criteria. So, but in everyday life, categorization is established and sustained by the socially required identificatory displays that proclaim one's membership in one or the other category. So, basically, it means na ang categorization natin is based on how we show ourselves physically and mentally. Also, in how we socialize other people. So, sex category in short ay lalaki at babae. The word placement, yung sa placement po, kasi is yung generation na natin ngayon na may gay at lesbian. Kasi kahit ipinanganak sila na lalaki at babae, na kung yung napupusuan nila ay opposite naman sa sex nila. Example po, yung nasa picture, girl, boy, lesbian, gay. Example po, kung paano sila makipag-socialize, ang gay, laging kasama ang mga babae, kasi doon sila mas komportable. So, yan po ang sex category. So, dito na po tayo sa gender. The standard na kailangan na ma-achieve para pumasok siya sa sex category na ito, for example po si Cheska, nakaklase ko po. Lalaki siya, pero gusto niyang pumasok sa kategorya ng babae and standard niya ay yung galawan is pang girl talaga at magpalaki ng dede o kaya magpalit ng ari. Yun po yung example ko. Kahit pumasok siya sa kategoryang yan, ay nasa gender pa rin siya ng lalaki. It's called evaluative standard so that the outcome whether is good or bad to other people. So, of attitudes and activities appropriate for one sex category. So, example naman po dito is yung sa gay. Example sa attitude ng gay po. Galawang babae siya. And sa activities niya is nagme-make up. Yun po example sa gay. Pag sa lesbian naman po is sa attitude, kilos lalaki siya. Sa activities niya is sa pananamit ng panglalaki kung baga ay boyish siya. Yun po example ng activities and attitudes. Example po dito is pag male ka kaya mong magbuhat ng mabigat. So sa female naman maglinis ng bahay kung baga ay yung magaan lang na trabaho. Kung baka yung mga lalaki daw is yung mabibigat na bagay na trabaho. Kung ba yung mga babae ay yung mga magagaan lang. Yun po. Yun po ang example ko po sa gender activities. Yung mga nakikita nyo po dito sa screen na pictures, dito po sa mga symbol of gender. So, yung una po doon is yung male. Yung sign po na yan is male sign. So, next po is female, yung female sign po yan. Yung hetero po, yung heteros symbol is symbolism of fertility, race, and polytheistic worship. So that next po is transgender. Symbol used to convey bisexuality, showing a female sign and male sign interlock. So yung sa next po is gay, double male symbol. And the lesbian symbols represent a lesbian or the lesbian community. Bisexual, boy to boy. Yun sa bisexual po na una is boy to boy daw po. Yung bisexual po na isa is girl to girl. Yun po yung pagkaintindi ko po dito. Sa gay po, two interlocking male symbols, a gay male or the gay male community. Yung isang lesbian, nagkapalit po ito yung lesbian kung nauna as a lesbian kung ito pong pangalawa. Ito po yung male symbols, a gay male or other gay male community. So yung transgender po na isa is commonly used to represent this is the transgender community. Itong last naman po is yung bilog. Ito yung asexual. For asexuality, sexless or genderless. Ito po yung ace ring, also known as a ace ring or wedding ring to symbolize marriage. Yun po yung ano yung nasa gender symbols. Dito naman po tayo sa mga flag po. Dito po nakalagay sa mga pictures, flag. Yung una po dito is yung LGBTQ Pride. Ito po yung the rainbow flag, also known as the gay pride flag or simply pride flag, is a symbol of lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender. So next po is the transgender symbols in lavender. So the next is the flag of bisexual pride, representing bisexuality, bisexual individuals, and bisexual community. The magenta stripe represent attraction to the same sex, while the blue stripe represents attraction to the opposite sex. The purple stripe, the resulting overlap of the blue and magenta stripes, represent attractions regardless of sex or gender. So the intersex pride, yung flag po nila is a way for the community to unite and unify under a symbol devoid and gender stereotypes. Yellow has long been seen as a intersex color or to represent those who do not fit the binary. The purple circle represent the wholeness of the intersex community, free from colors like blue and pink that are commonly seen as male and female respectively. Next is the gender queen pride. People generally do not subscribe to the gender binary and term norms, but may identify with neither, both, or combination of those genders. Lavender represent androgyny and queerness. White is represent a gender identity or gender neutrality. Green is the inverse of lavender and represent those whose identities which are defined outside the binary. So the pansexual pride is a pink-yellow Kian flag designed as a symbol for the pansexual community to increase its visibility and recognition and distinguish itself from bisexuality. And the last is asexual pride. Consists of four horizontal stripes, black, gray, white, and purple from top to bottom. The black stripe represents asexuality. The gray stripe represents the gray area between sexual and asexual. The white stripe sexuality, and the purple stripe is community. Yun po yung flag. Sa flag po. Sex. Example po dito sa person A. Yung pagkakaintindi ko po is sa... Based sa pagkakaintindi ko po, person A, lalaki siya. Pero hindi sila agree na upon biological criteria kasi gay siya. Kaya hindi pwede sa member of the female sex. So, dito po tayo sa sex category. For example po dito is, if can test. Na sinabi po dito is kung pasok siya sa criteria as a male and female, then they categories. Yun po. Sa gender, trans woman, an identity label adapted by male to female. Trans people to signify that they identify themselves as woman. Ito daw po yung male to female. Tapos yung mga bakla po na transgender na gustong maging babae. So dito man tayo sa trans man. And for example po dito yung mga lesbian na gustong maging babae na mag male, babae na gustong maging lalaki. May female to male. Yan po example ko.
Class and race can exertable exacerbate academic problems. Kumbaga sa mga boys, limbawa dito, karamihan sa mga boys in hindi active sa school. Karamihan sa kanila is mga bullying. Hindi naman tayo nakakita ng mga babae na nagbubuli. Karamihan mga, hindi nakakakita tayo, pero karamihan mga lalaki. Disciplinary problems, yan. Mga nag-escape, mga halimbawa dyan. And academic problems. Hindi sila masyado maano sa grade. Kumbaga, kaya hindi mataas yung grade nila. Yung mga boys kasi kung ano yung nila para po sa akin, kung ano yung naabot nila, basta pasado kahit tres, okay na yan. Hindi sila masyadong maano. Girls and schools receive higher report card grades, have a fewer disciplinary problems, more likely than boys to become valedictorians and go on to college. Malaking pagkakaiba sa boys. Kumbaga ang boys hindi masyadong active sa klase. Ito naman ang girls is active siya sa klase. Karamihan sa kanila is more likely than boys to become a valedictorians. Dahil sa mga matataas nilang grade, kumbaga nag-focus sila sa school kaya nag-focus sila sa pag-aaral. Yun. Kaya low self-esteem and less independence. Academic attitude. Sa writing or reading, para silang feminine. Pero pag sa hindi sila masyadong magbasa ng mga books, take fewer notes, hindi, study less, and play more. Mas nagko-concentrate sila sa mga plays like basketball, yan, nandyan. Other issues related to gender. LGBTQ. lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, queer, questioning, intersex, and asexual. Yan. And yun po yung meaning ng yan yung ano meaning ng LGBTQ.
So, sexual harassment, it is defined as an act or actions that is unwelcome or inappropriate for a girl. And even a boy can be sexually assaulted. So, what we call sexual harassment, it is something that should not be tolerated because even a simple touch can make someone traumatized or even one word can be the reason of someone's trauma or pain. So, for example of this, touching. So, he touching you. Yung kumbaga, minamay niya kanya na, which is, hindi ka sanay na hinihipuan ka. So, ayun po yung isang example ng sexual harassment. So, another example of sexual harassment is taking sexual pictures or videos, then ipopost niya ito. So, ayun po. Isa po yun sa sexual harassment. Another example is yung sasabihin ka ng with will, chicks. Ayun. Isa po yun sa sexual harassment. Then, another example of sexual harassment is undressing in front of you. Ayan, yung hinuhubaran ka na kahit na may suot ka naman pero hinuhubaran ka niya. Yung minamanyak yung tingin niya sa'yo, ayun. Isa po yun sa example ng sexual harassment. So, even a gay can experience a sexual harassment. So, sexual assault is something that should not be tolerated and know that no has always be a complete sentence. Just because you are a close or just because you are in a relationship and just because your friends doesn't justify an assault. So, ito po yung mga offensive na maaring makasira sa dignity ng isang tao. Maaring nyo pong ma-violate yung kanyang pakiramdam na which is maling-mali po yun. Okay, let's proceed to the consequences of a sexual harassment. So, the first one is student fear attending school. So, bakit nga ba takot na yung estudyante na umattend sa school? So, maybe sometimes may phobia na yung bata. May trauma na. Kaya takot na siya. Then, second is withdraw from activities. So, ito. Ito naman na po yung takot na siyang makihalubilo. Or sometimes, he or she will be avoiding social activities that the person previously enjoyed. And sometimes, he or she will avoiding making always excuses. Ayaw niya na din makipag-spend time to others. And sometimes, avoiding that involve meeting new people. Magiging less talkative na din po siya. Third is suffer and sleep or eating. So, ito naman na po yung will suffer and it will cause anxiety and depression. So, everyone can be a victim, not only the girls, but also boys. So, sexual assault will not stop unless you will stop tolerating it. But in many cases, victims were the one who feels shame rather than the offender who assaults them. Okay, let's proceed to know your rights. So, ito naman na po yung Republic Act number 7877, Anti-Sexual Harassment. So, ito naman na po yung kung alam mong tama ka, dapat ipaglaban mo, hindi yung hahayaan mong iharas ka na lamang. Lahat tayo may karapatang lumaban. So, many cases end up being unreported because victims are afraid of judgment coming from people who doesn't know anything. So, many cases were buried and victims ended up being haunted by those memories or nightmares they wanted to bury. So, ito naman na po yung many people are not aware of their rights, afraid to open their mouth because some victims end up being blamed for things that they cannot control. So, sometimes victim can simply forget. Then, the offender may live and continue his life normally, but the victim will forever be afraid and traumatized. That's why some acts are created for these victims to protect them and to make them realize that they are being heard and they are being protected. Okay, let's proceed to the gender inequality. So, when we call gender inequality, it is the different treatment or different opportunities given to males and females. So, sometimes, mas maraming na-hire sa mga boys rather than girls. Kasi nga, yung inaano nila is kaya nila ang ganito, kaya ng mga boys. Kaya nila magbuhat, kaya nila lahat. Now, without knowing if the boys can do it, also girls can do it. So, men are given more opportunities than women, commonly on the job opportunities. So, females are viewed differently even before ancient times, wherein in a lot of favorable treatment is given by men while women are not even allowed to leave their homes. So, gender inequality is when people are treated differently and according based on their genders.
Sexism. Sexism is based on belief, conscious or unconscious, that there's a natural order based on sex, or ito yung discrimination sa isang tao dahil lang sa kung anong kasarian meron ng isang tao. For example, sa mga gay, ganun din sa mga babae, at ganun din sa mga lalaki. Pag sa mga babae, nadi-discriminate sila dahil kunwari yung physical appearance nila hindi nagmamatch sa feminine, or parang sila ay medyo tibo-tibo, minsan doon na pumapasok yung discrimination or yung sexism. Isa pang example ng sexism is example yung isang pero yung isang member ng LGBTQ is may trabaho at yung schedule niya is a fixed schedule, tapos bigla-bigla na lang siyang ililipat sa night shift, ganun, nang wala siyang alam. At saka, ang magiging reason lang nung taong naglipat sa kanya sa night shift is dahil sa siya ay bakla, nandahil lang sa ayaw niya sa bakla, ganun. Yun yung pagiging sexism or sexist. Prejudice and or discrimination against people based on their real or perceived sex. Ganun din sa sexism. Pagdi-discriminate sa kung anong kasarian meron ang isang tao. Mapalalaki, babae, or member man ng LGBTQ. House Bill 1357 and House Bill 2264. Partners will be given all benefits and protections as granted to spouses in marriage under existing laws. Isa dito is yung inheritance right over properties acquired together, or yung mana na makukuha mo sa partner mo. and insurance membership with the Social Security System or SSS, Government Service Insurance System or GSIS, and PhilHealth. Kapag kayo ay kasal, or kapag yung dalawang tao ay kasal, pwedeng gamitin nung partner mo yung GSIS mo at saka PhilHealth or yung SSS mo just in case na ma-admit ka sa hospital. As the explanatory note of House Bill 1357 by Representative Bernadette Herrera D. states, civil union aims to be landmark as to provide civil right benefits and responsibilities to couples previously unable to marry by giving them due recognition and protection from the state. Or yung House Bill 37 is ginawa para magkaroon ng pagkilala sa pagsasama ng dalawang tao, whether they are same sex or not, or yung opposite sex, same or sexist. Prejudice and or discrimination against people based on the real or perceived sex. Ganun din sa sexism. Pag-discriminate sa kung anong kasarian meron ang isang tao. Mapalalaki, babae, or member man ng LGBTQ. House Bill 1357 and House Bill 2264. Partners will be given all benefits and protections as granted to spouses in marriage under existing laws. Sa dito is yung inheritance right over properties acquired together or yung mana na makukuha mo sa partner mo. And insurance membership with the Social Security System or SSS, Government Service Insurance System or GSIS, and PhilHealth. Kapag kayo ay kasal or kapag yung dalawang tao ay kasal, pwedeng gamitin nung partner mo yung GSIS mo at saka PhilHealth or yung SSS mo just in case na ma-admit ka sa hospital. As the explanatory note of House Bill 1357 by Representative Bernadette Herrera D. states, civil union aims to be landmark as to provide civil right benefits and responsibilities to couples previously unable to marry by giving them due recognition and protection from the state. Or yung House Bill 37 is ginawa para magkaroon ng pagkilala sa pagsasama ng dalawang tao, whether they are same sex or not, or yung opposite sex.
Domestic violence. 1 in 4 or 26% ever married woman aged 15 to 49 has ever experienced physical, sexual, or emotional violence by their husband or partners. In 2017's National Demographic and Health Survey. Okay, pag sinabi po natin domestic violence, ito yung nangyayari sa loob ng tahanan. Na pwedeng nangyayari sa mga asawa nyo o kaya sa mga anak o pangmamaltrato. May tatlong klase ng violence. Ito ang physical, sexual, and emotional. Basis of survey, 1 in 5 or 20% of women have ever experienced emotional violence. And 14% have experienced physical violence. 5% has ever experienced sexual violence by their current most husband or partner. So yan po yung mga surveys na nakalap ng NDHS about sa domestic violence. So in this slide, ito naman po ang Republic Act number 9262 or the Anti-Violence Against Women and Their Children Act of 2004. Ano nga ba ang nilalaman ng Republic Act 9262? Ito po ay an act defining violence against women and their children, providing for protective measures for victims, prescribing penalties, therefore, and for other purposes. So the Philippine government's initiative in addressing the issue on violence against women. So ito po yung mga acts of violence. First is attempting or threatening or inflicting physical harm to the woman or her child for the purpose of controlling her actions and decisions. Next is attempting to compel or compelling the woman or her child to engage in a conduct which the woman or her child has the right to desist from. Next naman po is causing or attempting to cause the woman or her child to engage in sexual activity which does not constitute rape by force or threat or force, physical harm or through intimidation direct against the woman or her child or his or immediate family. Another one is engaging in purposeful, knowing or reckless conduct, personally or through another. The alarms or causes substantial emotional or physical distress to the woman or her child. And lastly po is causing a mental or emotional anguish.